In a world of disappointment,
you're a beautiful girl. I would not let you walk alone.
She did. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe this.
Well, on Saturday, so I flew down this morning. I'll be heading back tonight.
Is that LeeAndre?
It is. LeeAndre's out there.
Take my hand and hold.
I just want to thank you for joining LeeAndre and Linda for this special celebration. We pray that you would bless this time, that we celebrate this marriage, and we celebrate all of who you are in their lives. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So who gives this woman away?
Her family, including Pat and I.
Awesome. Awesome. Thanks. So we're gathered here today as family and friends to join with the two of you in the sight of God of bringing the two of you together, LeeAndre and Linda, in holy matrimony, which God has said is a wonderful relationship that represents Christ's relationship with the church. A Christian marriage is a way of life given by God so that a husband and wife may provide for each other with companionship, help, comfort, joy, love, and warmth on days like today. You're agreeing together to love one another and to honor each other at all times. The foundation of this marriage begins well before the wedding, and the efforts of it will continue beyond this particular day. In 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8, the verses you've chosen says, love is patient and is kind. Love doth not envy or boast. It's not arrogant or rude. It doesn't insist on its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It doesn't rejoice at wrongdoing, but it rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, and hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they'll pass away. As for tongues, they'll cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. But love never ends. God puts us together, and he makes us one. That there are times that one may be able to speak the truth in love to the other and vice versa because, and it says love never ends. And I love that because God's love doesn't ever end. But Jesus has fulfilled those needs in each other. And when knowing that, you can love each other correctly. And so with loving each other correctly, the third, you can love each other compassionately. Because that love for each other says, oh my goodness, God loves me so much that he brought LeeAndre in my life. He loves me so much. He brought Linda into my life that you can love each other compassionately because of his love that he has for you. So as we go on this day, it's time for us to celebrate what the two of you have decided to do through your vows. So first, I want you to face each other and hold them. LeeAndre, as I say this, if you'll listen, and then you'll say, I will. LeeAndre, will you have Linda to be your wife, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Linda, will you have LeeAndre to be your husband? To live together the holy covenant of marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. LeeAndre and Linda, now we want to repeat the vow. So first, LeeAndre, please repeat after me.
I, LeeAndre, take you, Linda.
I, LeeAndre, take you, Linda.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And I do promise and covenant.
And I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Linda, if you would please repeat after me. I, Linda, take you, LeeAndre.
I, Linda, take you, LeeAndre.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I do promise and covenant.
And I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
As a sign and a seal of the love that you have for each other today, and for the covenant that you make this day, you've chosen to exchange rings. May I please have the rings? Each time you look at these rings, you'll be reminded of God's never-ending love for the two of you. No beginning, no ending. And so as you think about that love, every time you look at that, this is a commitment that you've made to each other. So LeeAndre, if you would take that ring and place it on Linda's finger and repeat after me. Linda, I give you this ring.
Linda, I give you this ring.
As a sign of the covenant.
As a sign of the covenant
we have made today.
We have made today.
Linda, would you take this ring, please? Place it on LeeAndre's finger and repeat after me. LeeAndre, I give you this ring.
LeeAndre, I give you this ring.
As a sign of the covenant.
As a sign of the covenant.
That we have made this day.
That we have made this day.
Now to each of those that are standing here with you, family and friends. As LeeAndre and Linda have committed to coming together as husband and wife, supporting, praying, and caring for each other, I'd like to ask you as family and friends to join with us in the following vow. Please listen and then respond to us. We as family and friends agree to pray for, encourage, support, and journey with LeeAndre and Linda as they begin their new lives together. If you will, please say, I will. Let's pray. Father, we come to you right now. We thank you for this time. Lord, as we are standing out in your creation, as we're enjoying this beautiful, but rather chilly day. Lord, we thank you that we can celebrate with LeeAndre and Linda what you have brought together. Lord, we thank you for what you're going to do in their lives, and we thank you for the fact that they're beginning this marriage relationship together under your upward, inward, outward love. Lord, we pray that you'd bless them as a family. You'd bless them as they bring their two families together. And Lord, we thank you for what you have done, for what you are doing, for what you are going to do in and through LeeAndre and Linda. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So LeeAndre and Linda, today you come before God and your family and friends to express your desire to be husband and wife by the clasping of your hands, by reciting your vows, and by exchanging your rings. You've expressed to God and each one of us your commitment to one another. I therefore have the privilege to pronounce you as husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no person separate. And LeeAndre, you may now kiss your bride.
What's that saying?
I want to give him one day.
What's that saying, LeeAndre? It's just you're giving me the house.
There you go.
The refrigerator and the door is all open for left. That was so funny because when we bought our first house, we were like,
it's all good.
Thank you.